Hi, my name is Tom Marshburn. I'm an emergency physician and a NASA astronaut. I've lived in space for about 6 months. Isolation is something that's a part of space flight. And so NASA trains us how to live in isolation, not only to be able to get by, but also how to be very effective as a team member so that we not only just survive it, but we're able to thrive in it. The way NASA does this is that it takes us in small teams and puts us in austere environments where we learn what we call good expeditionary behavior. We might be working together in the wintertime, backpacking in the mountains or in caves or in undersea laboratories. But it's in these environments that we learn how to practice good leadership, followership, good things like taking care of our team members as well as taking care of ourselves. And so now here are some of my astronaut physician colleagues to share some of their experiences both in training and in flight.
Hi, I'm NASA astronaut Kjell Lindgren. I flew in 2015 and spent 141 days living and working on the International Space Station. Now, Dr. Marshburn introduced some of the expeditionary behaviors that we utilize in that very challenging environment in low Earth orbit. And among those, leadership and followership, I think, are critically important. Now, it takes great leaders and great followers to work effectively. And you'll find yourself transitioning between those two roles over the course of a mission, of a week, or even over the course of a day. Leadership is particularly critical in difficult times, and it is a fundamental skill for safe and successful spaceflight. Leadership is built on the relationships that you have with your team, and on the faith and trust that you have in each other. And in my experience, great and effective leaders are less interested in the power and status that go with the position and really see it as a privilege, an opportunity to guide and serve their team towards some mission, objective, or goal. And when I was in the Air Force, one of the fundamental tenets of leadership was take care of your people. And if you take care of your people, if you provide for them, train them, empower them, communicate with them, set expectations, and help them meet those expectations, you are on a trajectory for success. I'm reminded of a time on the International Space Station during my mission. Now, I had the opportunity to fly with Scott Kelly during his one-year mission, and he was a commander of the station for part of that time. And one Friday afternoon, I was a little slow in my work. And the workday had officially ended, and yet I still had probably an hour's worth of work still to do. And I remember Scott floating into the module where I was at, and instead of harassing me, teasing me, or asking me, you know, why I was so slow, he simply grabbed a procedure, grabbed some tools, and asked me what he could do to help. And I think that's a great example of a leader serving their team, and it's one that I try to emulate in my own leadership. Thank you.
I want to say hello to the Davidson community on behalf of Dr. Marshburn. My name's Lee Morin. I'm a physician. I'm a retired Navy captain. I served with the U.S. Marines, with the U.S. Navy and Naval Aviation in the submarine service. And I was honored to fly on Atlantis in 2002. And got to do a couple of spacewalks there. I wanted to just mention a couple of issues with leadership that were very key in my training. You also see this in our T-38 training, where you'll have some of the best pilots in the world are the test pilots in the front seat in the astronaut corps, and they need to take a physician or a scientist like myself in the back seat, who has much, much less capability. And the goal there is for that front seater, who may be used to flying by themselves, take a rookie from their perspective and bring them along, nurture them, so that as a team, you're able to perform much better as a team than you would have individually, and that you can end up augmenting that experienced test pilot. And the two of you, if you're in a bad situation or moving on to a spaceflight together, you perform more effectively than either individual could by themselves. And the real enemy of teamwork, either from leadership or followership, is the ego. If the ego gets out of hand, the teamwork will not perform. And I would say that's one of the most important parts of the training. We exercise that throughout our astronaut training and in life in general. Leadership and followership is really a key.
Hello, I'm Michael Barrett, NASA astronaut, physician, and space life sciences freak. My background is in marine zoology and internal and aerospace medicine. I've spent 7 months in space, flying both the Russian Soyuz and the U.S. space shuttle to the International Space Station. So, a few words about communication. Во-первых, я хочу сказать, что Международная космическая станция – это двуязычное место. The International Space Station is a bilingual platform. Everybody has to be proficient in both English and Russian. And on my long flight, we had 5 nationalities present. So every day, we had to communicate across barriers of culture and language. But by far the biggest misunderstandings I've ever had have all been in English with fellow Americans. Your senses and knowledge help you to assess a situation, but it's communication that stands between your brain and the brains of your teammates. This is our predominantly verbal version of the internet, if you will. It's slower, but much more measured. And unlike ones and zeros, it is packed with subtleties and nuances that can make us so much more effective, or not. When something really matters, you need to know your stuff, and you need to know your people, but even that's not enough. You need to know how to communicate your stuff with your people. Checklists, standardized terminology and phrases, and training as a crew are some of what keep us synchronized and effective. So practice communication methods well before the mission, whatever your mission may be, so that you understand how to understand one another. Don't wait till your spaceship's on fire to get to know one another's communication styles. The same goes with your professional relationships. Thanks so much.
Hi, my name is Johnny Kim, and I'm a NASA astronaut from the class of 2017. I'm also a physician and former Navy SEAL, and today I'd like to talk to you about self-care. When I was a special operator, I had the privilege of serving as a combat medic and corpsman for my team. And this is the first time I heard about self-care, which initially to me sounded selfish. This idea that we put ourselves before other people seemed to contradict the oath that I swore as a medic and later as a physician. But that's not what self-care is. Self-care isn't selfish. Self-care is making sure you're the best version of yourself so that you can be an effective teammate and take care of the people that you love. This is especially vital during times of stress, and it's an essential ingredient to living a balanced life. Self-care applies to all of us in all aspects of our lives. As teachers, parents, physicians, even astronauts, we can be more whole if we are intentional about our physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual health, thus putting ourselves in a position to help other people. So I encourage you to be intentional about your self-care. Take a walk, go exercise, read a book, spend time with the people that you love.
Hi, I'm Frank Rubio, a member of the astronaut class of 2017. Prior to my time here at NASA, I served in the Army for 20 years. I flew Black Hawk helicopters for the first 8 years with deployments to Bosnia, Afghanistan, and Iraq. The following 12 years, I completed my family medicine training, and then I served as a flight surgeon at Redstone Arsenal and as a battalion surgeon for the 10th Special Forces Group. I wanted to talk to you about team care, which is one of the most important components of team skills. It's really important to be aware of how your actions and your words affect your teammates, but none of us are perfect. And so it's also important to schedule time at the end of the day, or maybe even every other day, to have those discussions about how we can each do better. It's also really important to know your teammates well. Oftentimes, it's hard for us to ask for help. We don't ever want to be the person that holds a team back or slows a team down. And so we might hesitate to ask for a helping hand. But when you know your teammates well, you understand the subtleties of when they're at that point. If we're doing training that's going to last a long time or just be really difficult, I try to make it a point to carry a snack, a Snickers bar, or something that my teammates might enjoy. And as we all get hangry throughout the day, it often helps to give them something like that. So ultimately, team care is about putting the needs of others first and considering your teammates in everything you do.
An astronaut crew of 3 to 6 people will start training together years before a flight, and in many ways we're like a family because we get to know each other so well. And then, of course, we launched and we're in space together in really in isolation. You know that NASA is really good at teamwork, and so we try to adopt what NASA knows about teamwork into our crew. Sometimes one event will bring all this together in very, very bright light. We had one time one of my crewmates noticed that there was a leak of a fluid outside the space station one day looking out the window, and we found out that it was coolant. Without the coolant, we couldn't maintain power to the space station, so we had about 2 days to go out and do a spacewalk and fix it. Typically, it takes about 9 weeks to get ready for a spacewalk. So with the hard work on the ground and with us applying some of these skills, such as being accountable to each other, making sure that we do our job well, but also own up to mistakes right away, and being able to manage options, understanding that while no one person can do everything, everybody can bring something to help solve the problem. And about a day and a half later, we went out, we did our spacewalk, it was successful, we fixed the leak. And in many ways, an event like that, a challenging event like that, brings people together, certainly brought us together. We were much closer as a crew after that event, and we're able to not only be safe and accomplish the mission, but have a good time.
Hello, my name is David Saint-Jacques. I'm a Canadian Space Agency astronaut. Before joining the space program, I worked as a family physician in a small Inuit village in the Canadian Arctic. There, I learned a lot of the team skills that I applied throughout astronaut training and that ultimately helped me be successful in my 6 months mission to the International Space Station. An essential team skill is group living. This is particularly challenging when you're confined with the same few people for a long time, as we are in space, and as a lot of us are right now during isolation. Three things help me for better group living in space and on Earth. Be organized with your personal belongings. Don't sprawl out. Be particularly careful with common areas. Respect other people's bubble. Every now and then, we all need some time alone. It's important to allow that. Don't let tension silently build up. Address any frustration or misunderstanding early before it develops into conflict. Good luck and stay safe.
The view of the Earth is breathtaking from space. This science that we have a chance to do up there is incredible. Living in zero gravity is endlessly fascinating. But what any astronaut will tell you when they come back, what we remember the most and what is most precious to us is the moments that we spend with our other humans up on board the space station and working with the ground. So I hope some of these skills mean something to you. And for us, they are essential not only for our enjoyment of our mission, but also for our survival as well.